And today, I am dedicating our practice to my beautiful cockatiel, Bizu, who passed last night. 23 years old. I looked up how long cockatiels usually live. They live for about 10 to 15 years in the wild and up to 26 years in captivity. So I feel good that he had a very long life, longer than any puppies are able to live, but it's hard because we were kind of attached to him since he was with us for such a long time. Obviously, you're attached to any fur baby or feathered friend who's with you. But as many of you probably know, Bizu means kiss in French. And that was one of his favorite things to do, was to give a kiss to whomever was holding him. And he will be missed, and he is loved. Again, we're starting to connect with the breath. Soles of our feet together, knees out wide. Breathing into a four count, holding to a four count, and exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction from the tops of your throats down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your heart to track the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. And exhale, 2, 3, 4. Again, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. One more time, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore, and allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension and soreness in your bodies and breathing it out, so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, Allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual. And it could be for you or for someone you love. I dedicate my practice today to Boisson, the best cocktail that anyone could ever hope to love. Again, who lived with us for 23 years. One of the sweetest animals you could ever imagine. Loved everyone. Loved to be held by everyone. Seal that intention with one deep inhale. And one deep exhale. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale, knees to the left, arms to the right. Look over that right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist. Opening up those right obliques. Releasing toxins as you do. Inhale back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over that left shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist. Inhale back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees, grab opposite elbows, rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Then grab your insteps, drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet, pull down with your hands in happy baby. Again, drag those shoulders back and down as much as you can. And then cross that right leg over left, wrap your feet, right arm under left, wrap your arms, maybe tuck in your shirts if you're me. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back, exhale, elbows to knees, inhale back, exhale, elbows to knees, two more or seven more wherever you are, inhale back, exhale, elbows to knees, inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Again, you can stop here or follow us. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back, exhale, elbows to knees. You can do two more, or if you've already stopped, that's fine. Inhale back, exhale forward. Inhale back, and exhale forward. Good job. Unwrap, unwind, give yourselves a hug. Rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys.
And then cross that left leg over right, wrap your feet, left arm under right, wrap your arms. Inhale as you touch your fingers and toes to the mat. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Again, two more or seven more. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. You can stop here or follow us. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale back. Exhale, elbows to knees. Two more if you're following us. Inhale back. Exhale forward. Inhale back. And exhale forward. Good job. Unwrap, unwind. Give yourselves a hug. And then from here, exhale those legs down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto the left side. Left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale that right knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Drag that right shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out. In infinity pose. Again, you can stay here or you can grab onto your calf, drag that leg down towards you if this is in your practice. Inhale that right knee in. Exhale, extend below you. Roll over onto the right side, right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale, that left knee in, grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you, drag that left shoulder back and down. Breathing in and out in infinity pose. Grab onto your calf, drag your leg towards you if this is in your practice. Inhale that left knee in, exhale, extend below you, draw those knees in, spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again, allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment. We'll do three or four of these and arrive at the tops of our mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose. Good job. Sitting up straight. Inhale that left arm all the way up. Exhale down to the right, onto that right elbow. Look up towards the ceiling. Open up those left obliques. Breathing in and out. We just watched a fun movie last night called, I think it's Black Adam. I think that's what it is, with Dwayne Johnson. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Inhale that right arm up. Exhale down to the left with Pierce Brosnan. And let's see who else is in there. Opening up those right obliques, breathing in and out. Trying to think of the other well-known people who are in there. It's obvious obviously one of those Marvel Comics movies. It was fun to see. Inhale back to center. Exhale first. Extend your legs. Flex your feet. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale as you open up to the right. Drag those shoulders back and down. And then drag that left elbow on the outside of your right knee, if this is in your practice, in twisted dandasana, making mudras with both sets of fingers. Excuse me, I'm sorry, my voice is hoarse. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you open to the opposite side, to the left. Drag that right elbow on the outside of your left knee. Open up to the side wall, making mudras with both sets of fingers, dragging your shoulders back and down. Inhale back to center. Exhale, reach, 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 reach. As far as you can with a flat back, place your hands on either side of your calves. Inhale, halfway up. Shoulders are back and down. Exhale, down, chin to shin. And then curl in Dandasana. Staff pose. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you bend that left knee, dragging your left heel in. Flex your right foot. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips, reach, 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 chin to shin, and curl in. Inhale, back up again. Exhale, as you draw that knee in. Place your left shoulder so that it's parallel with your left knee. Reach back with your left hand. Reach back with your right hand. And again, clasp hands if this is in your practice. Opening up to the side wall as much as possible through the breath. Shoulders are back and down. Good job. Inhale back to center. Cross that left leg over your right leg. Inhale, that right arm up. Exhale as you place it on the outside of your left knee. Open up to the back of the room. Placing that left hand behind you. Drag your shoulders back and down. Again, twisting, releasing toxins. Inhale, back to center. Exhale as you release your leg, shake it out. Inhale first. Exhale as you bend that right knee, driving your right heel in. Good job. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips, reach, 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 all the way down. Good job. Half Dandasana. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you draw that knee in. Place that right shoulder so that it's parallel with your right knee. Reach back with your right hand. Reach back with your left hand. Clasp hands. Open up to the side wall.
Back foot standing in the dead arm.
Shoulders are back and down. Inhale back to center. Cross that right foot over your left knee. Inhale that left arm up. Exhale as you place your elbow on the outside of your right knee. Open up to the back of the room. Right. and shoulders back and down. Inhale back to center. Exhale as you extend your legs and shake them out. Good job. Come back to Sukhasana. Place your fingertips on either side of your legs. Inhale that right arm up and over. Find your left ear and exhale over to the right, opening up that whole left side of your neck. Keep your left fingertips on the mat. Inhale, that right arm up. Exhale down. Inhale, your left arm up. Wrap your head, find that right ear. And exhale over to the left. Breathing in and out. Inhale that left arm up, exhale down. Place your hands on the mat, roll up into table. In table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees, and if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Inhale first. The cow, drag your spines down, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale. To cat, drag your spines all the way up. Gaze at your navels. Inhale. To cow. Look up towards the ceiling. Drag your spines down. Exhale. To cat, good job. Come back to a flat back. Look out beyond you. Inhale first. Exhale as you drag your hips to the right. Look at your left leg. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Look at your right foot. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. Inhale to center and exhale to the left. Good job. Inhale to center, curl your toes under, sit back on your heels. Again, make infinity symbols with your wrists if this is in your practice. Breathing in and out. Possibly draw those arms up overhead. Drag your shoulders back and down. Drag your pelvis bone in. Maybe draw those arms behind you. Fingertips touch. Pushing those fingertips up towards the crowns of your head. Interlacing your thumbs. Breathing in and out. Again, shoulders are back and down. Opening up your shoulders, your wrists, your fingers, your toes. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Rock forward on your elbows. Good job. Land the palms of your hands into the mat. Maybe tuck in your shirts if you haven't yet. Curl your toes under, inhale first. Exhale back to down dog. Again, maybe walking your dog if this is in your practice. Don't have to. Again, dragging your hearts towards your thighs as much as possible, pressing that area between your index finger and thumb into the mat. Breathing in and out. Good job. Come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat. Step or jump up. Inhale halfway up, Kapharda. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Again, in Uttanasana, working towards getting the palms of your hands onto the mat. Possibly wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows. In standing Dandasana. Slowly exhale down once again. Inhale halfway up. Shoulders are back and down. Exhale down. Slightly bend your knees. Inhale all the way up. Swan dive backward. Hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra, bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, halfway up. Step or jump back. Draw those elbows in. Go through your vinyasa. Paramitas and down dog. Good job. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Inhale that right leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split. Exhale, swing it into a lunge. Plant your back foot. Inhale all the way up to Virabhadrasana 1. Good job. Exhale, Virabhadrasana 2. Reach, 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 reach. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Exhale back. Straighten that front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Pull that left hand back. Push that right hip forward. Float those arms up again. And then reach, 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 reach. And burst into Trikonasana. Good job. Keep on pulling that left hip back, right hip forward. Bend your front knee. Coming into side angle. Take a wrap. Maybe take a bind, reach under and grab that left wrist. Dragging that left shoulder down towards the mat, opening up your hearts to the side wall as much as possible. Bizu unfortunately broke a wing from flying fairly early on. Was never able, I don't think he broke a wing, I think he just knocked off some feathers, was never able to grow them back. Wasn't able to fly, so I know that he's flying now. Such a sweet boy. Inhale. North and south, look towards the front of the mat. Launch off your back foot, tip yourselves into Ardha Chandrasana, standing half moon. Again, maybe take a bind if this is in your practice. Opening up your hearts to the side wall even more. Release that foot, bend your front knee, tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana 2. Good job. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that right leg back. And go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Walking your dog. My sweater's coming untucked, so I will tuck it back in again. Sorry. Again, we're in down dog, walking the dog. Inhale through your nose and side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Inhale that left leg all the way up. Exhale, swing it through to a lunge. Plant that right foot. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana 1. Warrior 1. Exhale. Virabhadrasana 2. Reach, 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 reach. Palm up, exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Exhale back, straighten your front leg. Place your hands on your hips, pull that right hip back, push that left hip forward. Float those hands up. Reach, 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 reach. And then burst. Into Trikonasana. Drag those shoulders back and down. Bend that front knee. Coming into side angle. Take a wrap. Possibly take a bind, reach under and grab that right wrist. Bound side angle. Open up, north and south. Look towards the front of the mat. Tip yourselves off of that right foot. Plant that left hand in Ardha Chandrasana. Maybe bend your knee, taking a bind, breathing in and out. Release, bend your right knee, tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down, kick that left leg back. and go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Good job. Walking the dog. Inhale through your noses, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Good job. And then from here, let's go ahead and inhale that right leg all the way up once again. Exhale, swing it through to the top left. Right knee down, left knee down, left top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Maybe take Venus Mudra. And exhale, forward. Placing that left cheek on the mat. Again, in resting pigeon. Breathing in and out. Back towards your waist. Keep your shoulders safe. You can be on your left cheek, you can be on your right cheek, you can be on your elbows, you can be on your backs, wherever you want to be in resting pigeon. Opening up that right hip, releasing any unwanted emotion. Breathing in and out. Slowly inhale as you walk those hands back again, coming off on that right hip. Swing your left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to your right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find your right hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. In the Mariandrasana twist, releasing toxins, massaging our internal organs. Inhale back to center, exhale. As you release that left leg, moving into Janushasana. Inhale both arms all the way up. Twist to the left and exhale down. Shin to shin and then just curl in. Inhale. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you release your right leg. Shake it out. Come up to the tops of the mats in Malasana. Possibly plant your hands in front of you, rocking back and forth on your tippy toes, finding that sweet spot. Rocking forward into Bakasana, if this is in your practice, in crow pose. Don't feel like you have to. You can stay where you are, inhaling from your root chakra all the way up to your crown chakra and exhaling down again. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Place your hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up to Ardha. Take a giant step back with your right foot. Walk your left foot all the way across. Left knee down, right knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Take Venus Mudra. And exhale down. Right cheek comes down to the mat. Again, breathing in and out. In resting pigeon. When you're ready, draw those arms back down towards your waist. Release. Again, opening up that left hip. Releasing any unwanted emotion that you may be storing there. Breathing in and out. In resting pigeon. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Coming off on that left hip, swing your right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that left foot in and that left elbow in. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find your left hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. Shoulders are back and down. Mariandrasana twist. Inhale back to center. Extend your legs and shake them out. Bend your knees. Arms are out on either side of your legs. Inhale those feet up. Flex your feet. Exhale as you open up. Shoulders back and down. Come back. Grab on to your big toe with your index finger and thumb. Exhale. Dragging those shoulders back and down. Sitting up straight. Inhale back. Arms are out on either side of your knees. Exhale, inch by inch. Vertebra by vertebra down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth. Then grab your block. Place your heels just below your sit bones. Inhale as you push your hips up, placing the block underneath your sacrum on the highest, second, or third levels in a supported bridge. Again, release onto the block. You can either draw those arms overhead and walk your feet out, or stay where you are, opening up that lower back region as much as possible. Draw those arms back overhead, walk your feet in. Inhale as you push your hips up, releasing the block. And exhale down, draw those knees in for a hug. Good job. Now let's move into an inversion. Either leg straight up. Again, flexing your feet, allowing the circulation to come back down to your vital organs, back down to your brain. And possibly push your hips up. Walk your shoulders under in a shoulder stand. Looking like a candlestick, feet are in Barbie feet. Maybe draw those toes overhead in Halasana or plow pose. Possibly bend your knees, placing them around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, coming back down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug. Inhale through your noses, side out, inhale. Good job. Exhale that right leg down. Inhale your left arm up overhead. Exhale as you push your left knee over to the right. Look over your left shoulder and breathe. Full body twist. Inhale back to center. Draw those knees in. Exhale that left leg down. Inhale your right arm up overhead. Exhale as you push your right knee over to the left. Look over that right shoulder and breathe. Inhale back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. And again, inhale through your noses, sigh it out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso. Palms are up to receive, down to ground. Starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads. Relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Reach your arms overhead. Extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position facing the front of the room. Legs are crossed, hands are at Anjali Mudra, heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Monday. Again, dedicating this practice to Boisson, my beautiful cockatiel. Namaste. Thank you all. So glad that you were here today. And I'll see you tomorrow. I hope everybody's doing well. I'm going to go ahead and stop recording.